let's see now how we can take the power method and change it into one where we compute the eigenvector associated with the eigenvalue that is seconds in magnitude. So that would be lambda 1. So here we have our power method. Let's make sure that we now save this as, let's call it power method lambda 1. And then let's see, what do we want to do? Well, every occurrence of lambda 0, we should really call lambda 1. So let me go ahead and make all of those changes. And V, we're now going to return V1. And we are going to pass in a vector associated with the eigenvalue largest in magnitude. Let's call that X0, that gets passed in. And we need to rename this routine lambda 1. And I really should go and change the comments here, but let's not bother with that. And then every occurrence of V should become V1, and then every occurrence of lambda 0 should become lambda 1. So let me just go ahead and do that, and we'll just cut to where I'm done with making those changes. Okay, so I think I've made all of those changes, and now let's actually change the algorithm itself. The idea now is that instead of setting v1 equal to the vector x normalized to have length 1, what we want to do is take x and subtract out the component of x in the direction of x0. Now we're going to assume that x0 is of length 1, so that means that we need to do this right here. And then once we actually have computed that, then we want to normalize that vector that we start with to have length 1. Now, to test this, what we need to do is go to test subspaces and uncomment the section that calls this power method lambda 1. And we do that by simply setting the 0 to 1. Now, we still need to run the power method because we need a vector associated with lambda 0. But we don't necessarily want to do all of the reporting along the way. So let's set illustrate equal to 0 so that we don't get the graphs associated with running the power method, that we don't get the intermediate results printed out. So if I now execute test subspace iteration, it'll very quickly run the power method, and then it'll immediately start reporting on this method that tries to home in on the next eigenvalue. So let's have a look here. And sure enough, it starts homing in on the eigenvalue 4. Now let's observe this for a little bit. It gets close. Ooh, but now actually it's starting to lose accuracy and it's starting to move away from the eigenvalue equal to 4. And actually it's starting to home in on the eigenvalue equal to 5, the one that's largest in magnitude. And after 50 iterations, it completes this process. And if we now look at the graph of what eigenvalue this method homed in on, we notice that for a while it does just fine and starts homing in on the eigenvalue equal to 4. But then apparently a little bit of error starts sneaking in the direction of the eigenvector associated with lambda 0. And once that happens, that gets amplified over and over and over again. And eventually we again start pointing in the direction of the eigenvector associated with lambda 0. So that's the problem. Noise creeps in, and then this method starts acting like the power method as opposed to this power method that had subtracted out the component in the direction of x0.